Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at 10 more things to try on your Mac after upgrading to macOS Monterey. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So previously I showed you 10 things to try on your Mac after upgrading to Monterey. Here are 10 more things. So let's look at a really big new feature, which is FaceTime's ability to allow you to include people who don't have Macs, iPhones, or iPads. Now when you're in FaceTime and you want to start something new, you can go to Create Link. And here you can decide how to get the link. So let's just say copy the link for now. And you can see there's an upcoming section. So this is a FaceTime conversation that hasn't started yet. We can start it here and join it. So now it's me alone in FaceTime. I can click here and I can add people or share the link. So let's share the link and I'm going to copy the link. Now the link itself is just a web link. So let's go into Safari and I'm going to paste this link in. And it's this really long URL here. And when I go to it, it's actually going to allow me to join the FaceTime call inside of the web browser. And it's going to use my microphone and my camera from right inside the browser. So I'll join. And now you can see I have to wait to be let in. Here you can see somebody has tried to join. I can say OK. And I'm now talking to myself. But this web browser could be anywhere. It could be on another Mac. It could be on a Windows computer. It could be on an Android device. Another FaceTime feature is voice isolation. You can get to that by clicking on Control Center here. And when you're in FaceTime, you have the ability to change the mic mode. Click there and you'll be able to go from standard to voice isolation. And if you have the right mics, you can even go to wide spectrum. Now in addition to Notes having tags as a new feature, Reminders also have tags. But they're a separate field. So if I go and look at this tag here, you can see I've got the title, I've got notes about this reminder, and I've got tags right here. So I could add tags for any note. So now you can see I've got tags for both these reminders and I could look at all the reminders with a specific tag in the sidebar here. So this could help you organize your reminders across different lists. So whether you're accessing passwords in Safari or using the new ability to access passwords in System Preferences, you now have the ability to edit the password and add a two-factor verification code. So you click here and you enter a setup key. So a lot of services like Google will give you this special setup key when you set up two-factor authentication. If you paste that in here, you'll then have the two-factor code as part of your saved password. And you'll be able to enter in your ID, your password, and your two-factor code all at once in Safari and in other places. In System Preferences under Apple ID and iCloud, there's also Private Relay. So if you have iCloud Plus, which is any level of paid iCloud service, then you could turn this on and it will mask your IP address and also encrypt your data in a similar way to a VPN. It doesn't have all the features of a VPN, like you can't choose the country that it appears you're in, but it gives you the basic protection. So let's say you want to use Split View. If you go to the green button here, tile to the left side, choose something to go to the right side. Previously, if you wanted to change one of these two, you would have had to exit Split View and basically create a new Split View with the two things you wanted. But now you can move the pointer over the green button again, and one of the options you'll get is Replace Tiled Window. And now you can select something else to go into that spot. A new feature of notifications is the ability to mute a source for a little while. So for instance, I've got a few messages here. And if I click here and then on the three dots, you can see I can mute for 1 hour for the entire day or turn off this notification. So if I wanted to stop getting notifications of text messages, I can mute for 1 hour like that. In the past, a lot of people have asked me if there's a way to change the pointer on the screen. And there finally is now. In System Preferences, you can go to Accessibility and then you can go to Display Pointer. And now you can change the size of the pointer. And you could also change the outline color and the fill color. So you can make it something different. Let's do red for the fill and for the outline we'll do black. And now we've got a pointer that looks like this. Anytime you want, you can just hit reset to reset those colors. There's also a new feature in System Preferences. If you go to the System Preferences menu item here, there's Erase All Content and Settings. This actually takes you to a new hidden app called Erase Assistant. And it'll walk you through all the steps of erasing all the content on your Mac. So you no longer have to reboot into a special mode and use some advanced tools in order to do this. It could be done in a similar way now to doing it on the iPhone or iPad. And here's one last thing that MacBook owners are going to love. If you go to System Preferences Battery, and you go to battery here, there's now a low power mode, just like on the iPhone. So if you really need your battery to last all day and it's just not quite making it there, you can turn on low power mode or turn it on at some point during the day if you notice you're getting low and you know you won't be able to charge up again anytime soon. So there's some more new things to check out in macOS Monterey. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.